My name is John Wellington Wells. I'm a dealer in magic and spells, in blessings and curses and ever-filled purses, in prophecies, witches and knells. If you want a proud foe to make tracks, if you melt your rich uncle in wax, you but to look in on the resident in number 70 Simmery Axe. We've a first rate assortment of magic, and for raising a posthumous shade, with effects that are comic or tragic, there's no cheaper house in the trade. Love filter with quantities of it, and for knowledge if anyone burns, we're keeping a very small profit, a profit who brings us unbounded returns. For he can prophesy with a wink of his eye, preview security, interview surety, sum up your history, clear of a mystery, humor proclivity, foreign nativity, foreign nativity. He outdances oracular, bogey spectacular, tensible, tragical, merisome, magical, fat autonomical, solemn or comical, and if you want it, he makes a reduction of taking the quantity whole. If anyone anything lacks, he'll find it already in stacks, if he'll only look in on the resident in number 70, Simmery Axe. He can raise hosts of ghosts, and that without reflectors, and creepy things with wings, and gaunt and grisly spectres. He can fill you crowds of shrouds, and horrify you vastly. He can rack your brains with chains, and a gibberings grim and ghastly. Then if you plan it, he changes organity with an urbanity full of satanity, fetches humanity with an inanity, fatal to vanity, driving your folks to the verge of insanity. Parentology, in demonology, electrobiology, mystic notology, spirit philology, high sociology, such is his knowledge, isn't the matter, require an apology. Oh! My name is John Wellington Wells. I'm a dealer in magic and spells, in blessings and curses and ever-filled purses, in prophecies, witches and knells. And if anyone anything lacks, he'll find it already in stacks, if he'll only look in on the resident in number 70, Simmery Axe.
I have sent for you to consult you on a very important matter. I believe you advertise a patent oxyhydrogen love at first sight filter.
Sir, it is our leading article.
Now, I want to know if you can confidently guarantee it as possessing all the qualities you claim for it in your advertisement.
Sir, we are not in the habit of puffing our goods. Ours is an old established house with a large family connection, and every assurance held out in the advertisement is fully realized.
Oh, Alexis, don't offend him. He'll change us into something dreadful. I know he will.
I am anxious, from purely philanthropical motives, to distribute this filter secretly among inhabitants of this village. I shall, of course, require a quantity. How do you sell it?
In buying a quantity, sir, we should strongly advise your taking it in the wood and drawing it off as you happen to want it. We have it in 4.5 and 9 gallon casks. Also in pipes and hogsheads for laying down. And we deduct 10% for prompt cash.
I should mention that I am a member of the Army and Navy stores.
In that case, we deduct 25%.
Aline, the villagers will assemble to carouse in a few minutes. Go and fetch the teapot.
But Alexis...
My dear, you must obey me, if you please. Go and fetch the teapot.
I'm sure Dr. Daly would disapprove of it.
And how soon does it take effect?
In 30 minutes. Whoever drinks of it loses consciousness for a period, and on waking falls in love, as a matter of course, with the first lady he meets, who has also tasted it, and his affection is at once returned. One trial will prove the fact.
Good. Then, Mr. Wells, I shall feel obliged if you will at once pour as much filter into this teapot as will suffice to affect the whole village.
But bless me, Alexis, many of the villagers are married people.
Madam, this filter is compounded on the strictest principles. On married people, it has no effect whatever. But are you quite sure that you have nerve enough to carry you through the fearful ordeal?
In the good cause, I fear nothing.
Very good. Then we will proceed at once to the incantation.